Youth Secretary for the whole Philippines. And he is also one of the instructors of our 8 Bible colleagues in Davao City, Apostolic Institute of Ministries. And he is an advisor for the senior class. And we really thank the Lord that God has given him a call in his heart. And it's a miracle that he was able to get his visa. Amen. And we miss them very much, and we want them to be here. So I would like to call our son, Pastor Philip Willie. I wake up 12, 1, then 2, then 3, and now I wake up 4. That's good. I'm getting there. And I would not be able to say everyone, greet everyone, because we already been recognized, guys. But only here in Canada, I get to wear almost every day a suit and a tie. But there, you know, it's a simple living, and it's a miracle by itself coming here. It's a dream came to reality, and it was 15 years old when I desired to even come to the maple syrup and all of that. And now I'm even standing here, and you guys are so awesome. And the presence of God is here right now.
Amen.
I would like to end today. I would like to end today that we will just make God greater in this place. That's the bottom line.
Yes, yes.
It's not me here, you know. It's Him here.
Yes.
I'm just nobody. These guys here are the generals in this area. But among all of that, we are here because of the great God that we serve.
Yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord. And I would not, I would remiss to thank you guys all in general, my parents especially, those who really made the way for me to come here. Without further ado, let's proceed to the word of the Lord. Open your Bible with me in John chapter 14, verse 12 to 14. And then we will proceed to 1 Corinthians 13:13. For everyone who traveled, to those who traveled coming here, I know it's really hard. And I don't know if you guys do siesta here. You know, when we do afternoon service, everybody gets sleepy. I don't know.
Sunday afternoon,
yeah. Yeah, okay. So sounds normal. Okay, so I hope you will not fall asleep, you guys. And, you know, even if my English is messed up, you know, I know that we can still know how to worship Him, right?
Yes.
It says here, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto the Father. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye ask anything in my name, I will do it. Yesterday I emphasized on the point that before you can even ask from the Lord, there is greater works. God is not a lazy God. He honors the faith and the works of people. And He said, greater works shall you do. And you shall ask for
1 Corinthians, verse 13 and 13, it says, "And now abideth faith, hope, charity, these three. But the greatest of this, these is charity." I will bring to you the simple subject that says, greater than now. I'm sorry about that. What happened? We can edit it. Greater than now. Would you just bow your heads and let's go to prayer. Lord, hide me behind the shadow of your wings. God, we did not come here just for fellowship, just for food, just for singing. We came here, God, because we are hungry and thirsty and have a heart for us to live today. God, whatever our hindrances, God, we present our way. You are greater than all of those things, God. Let it be that the fire, my God, that is in the Philippines, the fire over all the nations in Canada. Lord, we will just worship you in the spirit of truth. And we will just worship you because you are the God who is greater than now. In Jesus' name we pray. Clap your hands and worship our God this morning. You can ask it now, ladies and gentlemen, greater works than now. When you talk about works, it tells us, and it is translated as either works or things or miracles by itself. And I do know that every church that God has ordained is a miracle by itself. Man cannot be trusted by himself, but men are used by God because he is the will maker. He can pave the way for those simple men, and he can use those little people or those guys that are available, unavailable, unqualified, and he can use them for his goodness. A church that emphasizes fruit of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, goodness, great gentleness, meekness, temperance, and faith is a miracle. When God said that the greater works than these shall he do, it does not mean that we are going to be greater than Jesus Christ. No one is greater than Jesus Christ. Experience being discriminated, but what one thing I do know, when when you give your life to the Lord. When you give your life to the Lord, it does not matter if you discriminate me. It does not matter if you look down on me. As long as God and I stand, as long as God and I stand, you are still, you know me. I love you. I appreciate you. When you love the God and I stand, and I tell you what I have promised for you. Greater than now. Praise God. And I am so glad that we can ask anything in His name.
Wow.
Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Do you have a prayer request? Do you have something to ask from the Lord? If you have something to ask from the Lord, would you just lift up your hands? Hallelujah. And just Lord, you know their hearts. You know our desire. You know our need, God. Praise God. Jesus said, the Pharisees told Jesus, Master, which is the great commandment in the law? Pastor Willie, my pastor and my father, said this, Thou shalt love the Lord your God with all your heart. Everybody say heart.
Heart.
With all your soul. Everybody say soul.
Soul.
And with all thy mind. Everybody say mine. This is the first great commandment. And second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. What are these works are you talking about that we're going to do and we're doing now? You have to understand that if it was not because of God, we are here people of faithless or faithless people.
Yes.
If it was not because of God,
right,
we are hopeless.
Right.
If it was not because of God, we do not love.
Right.
We do not care. We are selfish people.
Uh-huh.
But the Bible says, now abideth.
Yes.
Wow.
Now, what happened is, when Jesus went inside of you, it abided something. Abided faith. Now, not before, everyone was faithless. Now, when Jesus came into our life, you, this person are here right now, you guys, we can now wear a suit like this. But before, our life was a mess.
Right?
But when when God abided in our life, now faith abided. Now hope abided. Now love abided. Before, we cannot even love ourselves.
Yes.
When we face our mirror, we almost curse ourselves.
Yes.
Just drop dead and die.
Fine.
But now, oh, by the grace and mercy of God. Yes. One of these, greater than now, is faith.
Wow.
One of the foundations